Hi guys, this is a tutorial of my F-14 Tomcat with the swinging wings. One and two. And this will be a long tutorial. Actually, there are so many folds, so many fold inversions, so many squash folds. But let's start. We start as usual with the A4 format, and we start folding half. Okay, now open the fold, measure from this point along this edge 75 millimeters, then turn the paper and measure here 12 millimeters. Now turn the paper again and make a fold from this vertex here. Just make a pinch with your finger in this way and fold up to the point where the 12 millimeter mark will match with this edge. And now don't fold all along the paper, just fold until the center line up to here. And you can see that your fold matched the mark that we have done. Now open, let's do the mirror of this fold in this way. This we have done a lot of times. Then, as we have done for the Sukhoi SU-24, fold in this way. Now open this fold, open everything, do this, and let's do the mirror of the fold that we have just done in this way. Now we can open all folds and compose our water bomb. Now turn one wing and measure 25 millimeter from this point along this edge. Make a mark and fold in this way. Do directly the mirror fold, matching exactly what is underneath. And now measure 43 millimeters from this point along this edge. And 11 millimeters from this point along this edge. and make your fold. The mirror, now measure 31 millimeters from this point along this edge. And make a fold from the same point up to here, this point here. Now make another fold from this point up to the top of the airplane in order to do the squash fold. Fold. You will see this fold now exceeds a little bit the line of the fuselage, but it is okay. And squash. Paper. Do the same thing in the other side. 31 millimeters. The other fold. And squash. Now measure 15 millimeters from this point along this edge. Did the same concept than the Sukhoi Su-24, only with different dimensions. Make a fold matching this point to the marked one. Sorry, make it like this. Okay, let's fold the this way. And let's do a small squash fold like this. This is what you must get. Let's do it also the other side, 15 millimeters. Here. and do the squash. Now take 20 millimeters from this point along this edge. And make a fold from this point up to this point here. This means you have to fold as maximum as you can. Without breaking the paper. Make this fold strong because we will need to invert this fold later on. Now turn the paper and do just the same thing. 20 millimeters. And fold, trying to make it really the same shape than the fold underneath. Let's make this a little bit stronger. Okay, now I want you to make a fold from this point up to this point here. Fold only one side. Try to reach exactly this point. And the same thing in the other side. Okay, I'm lacking some precision here, but really I'm trying to make this tutorial not too long. Now, what we need to do, we need to open all folds. All the folds that we have done, except the folds of the water bomb. Open, open. And now rotate one wing. Now you can see this fold here. This fold, I will mark it with the pencil. Just to make it more visible. Now we need to make a fold to fold this portion here, only this portion, and make this edge matching with this line in this way. fold it up to this fold here. And then from the point that is the crossing of the fold that we have just now, that we have done just now with the first fold of the wing shaping, let's mark a small point and let's make a fold from this point up to this point here, the center line of the plane. A small fold in this way. And now turn back the wing in this way, but at the same time fold along the two folds that we have just now. Just fold it like this and squash, and you will create another fold. This small fold here. So this in this way. I will show you in this way, it will be more clear. Okay. Now let's open the other wing and let's do the same. I will first mark with my pencil the fold. Then I will fold in this way up to here. And then from this point here up to the center line of the plane. And then I will fold back again in this way. Okay, we don't need this fold right now. We will use this fold later on. Now we need to open and we need to make an inversion that is similar to the one that we have done for the Sukhoi SU-24. But we will invert not only the fold pertaining to this side, but also the fold pertaining to this side. So we will make a full fold inversion. Now here you can see the scheme of what we have just now. Okay. And here you can see the scheme that we have, that we must have. So let's start with the first fold. This one will be a mountain fold. Then these two will be two valley folds. Then again, there will be a mountain fold, this one, and a valley fold this one here. Let's follow the same scheme here. The first one will be a mountain fold. Then we have the two folds. This one will be two valley folds. Then we will have this fold as a mountain fold. And this one as a valley fold. Then again, the two folds here, the two fold parallel, one in one side of this line and the other one at the other side of this main line, will be two valley folds. So it will be this one and this one here. Then again, this fold will be a valley fold, and this fold and this fold will be two mountain folds. So the two mountain fold first. And the valley folds. Forget about all the other folds for now, and let's try to close our wings. In the same way then as we have done in the Sukhoi SU-24, but we need now to fold this one in both sides. Put the fold the wings in this way, and close . Pay attention not to create other folds. You need to fold exactly on the along the existing folds. And this is what you have. By the way, this will be the pivot point then to create our swinging mechanism. Now, let's do the same in the other side. Now we can even open this one. Let's do the same with our mountain fold and valley fold. Valley fold this one, valley fold this one, then we will have this one mountain fold, this one mountain fold. This one and this one valley fold. Then we will have mountain fold, mountain fold. Valley fold, the one in the middle, and valley fold these two fold here. Let's close it. We are almost there, but now I want to check if the wings are more or less the same, in the same position. Otherwise, the plane will not be perfect. So let's close both. Okay, more or less we are there. Now, there is still another inversion that we need to do. Now, I ask you to notice on the diagram the two folds marked with the yellow arrows. This fold, these two folds, as you can see, are inverted only in one side of the wing. And this is exactly what we are going to do. So, open one wing and invert the two folds that are marked in the diagram. We are talking about this fold here and this fold here. In order to do this, we need to open one and two, and let's do the same also in the other side, otherwise we will have to open it again. Mounting fold and mounting fold. Now, what happened? When we close again our wings on the fold that we have done, and now this operation should be quite easy to do. Like this. We need to squash down these two folds in order to create a pocket in this way. Okay, and now you close it again. So, with this operation, we have created here one pocket and here one paper that at the end of the model we will insert this piece of paper inside the pocket. But this will be done only at the very end of our modeling. Let's do the same in the other side. Let's refold the everything and let's squash down this. It's more difficult for me to do it in this side. Okay. And let's fold. In this way. So we have the front part that is a piece of paper protruding from the so-called the pancake of the F-14, and at the bottom side you have a pocket where you will slide the paper inside at the end. So we have done a big part of our job, but of course it's not over. Now, turn the wing in this way and let's refold this one. You remember the fold we have done before? Now, we have what we have to do now is to fold this one inside and to reclose the wing, and this will create a fold, this fold here. Okay, I make now and then I will show you in the other side. Let me bring this one like this. In this way, you will create this fold here. So let's do it in the other side again. So bring this fold under in this way up to this point here. Refold the wing up to here. Refold the wing. Actually, you can make a small fold like this if you want, in order to make it easier. I repeat, with this wing I am a little bit more clumsy, but this is what you must get at the end. Let's make this fold as similar as possible to the one on the other side. In this way. Try to make it perfect, because okay. Now, in a similar way, let's take this fold, let's bring it inside, and let's refold also the wing. This is a little bit easier to do, I hope so. Okay. Now we have completed the shaping of the wings. Now we need to shape now the pancake. Let's measure now 7 millimeters from this point here, the crossing between the wing and the pancake itself, 7 millimeters this way. Let's make a fold from this point up to this point. The fold, and let's make now an inside the reverse fold of this fold here. Let's squash it inside. Let me make this fold a little bit stronger. And now we need to squash all these paper in this way. Let's do the same thing in the other side. Now I will show you this fold a little bit more closely. Open it and squash completely this fold inside. Now let's make another fold more or less 10 millimeters from this point here, this point, 10 millimeters. Let's bring it more or less from the center line. Let's bring it 11 millimeters here. Oh my God, no, I've done a big mistake here, sorry. I don't know how did this happen, but the squash fold was done wrong. In this way, I will show more closely. Now you need to push inside. This fold in this way. Okay, now you can measure 10 millimeters from this point here. And from the center line along this edge, 11 millimeters. And you can make a fold connecting these two points. You will see that you will reach almost the maximum that you can fold. By the way, check if you don't break the paper, you can fold a little bit less if you want. But the important is that you don't break the paper. And let's also make an inversion on this. Let's do the same here. Here is actually a little bit more precise. 10. Fold and invert. And then just take this one and fold it in this way about 7 to 8 millimeters in this way. Okay, we are here now. We have just completed the shaping of the pancake. Let's turn this wing and let's make a small fold from this point here up to the center line of the model. We need actually this fold to be able to fold later on the the tail, and let's do the same here. See, you are reaching almost the maximum that you can fold on the wings. Okay. Now, we can start with the tail. Let's measure 67 millimeter along the center line. Actually, I have already done the fold because I made a mistake before. Mark 67 millimeter. And because I want to be very precise, I also mark a 67 millimeter here and a 67 millimeters here. So pinch on this point and do matching the center line, do your fold. Now let's make another fold by bringing this edge up to this edge. In this way. Okay, now in this particular model the tail portion is placed underneath the wings. This is not the same than in my other models, and we can obtain this by inverting all the folds of the tail. Let's see how. Now at the moment let's invert these two folds in this way and in this way, and let's slide this paper inside here between the pancake and these two folds here. We'll do it in this way. Okay, now we need to fold the tail portion along with the fuselage. And we will do it in this way. I will show you from this side. You see, when you reach this line here, you can see this line, which is the line of the fuselage, you have to fold just matching this line. I will now do it looking at the model from this side, because otherwise I will not be precise. This way. And this is the reason why we have done the last fold of the wings. Otherwise we will not be able to fold in this way, by clapping the wings, actually. Now, we will open again. We will now invert these folds again, because all the folds that we are doing now, we have to do in the normal way, like in the F-15, and then we will have to invert all of them. So, with the model in this position, invert the fold that we have just done, and let's do the mirror fold of this. In this way. Okay, now let's measure 34 millimeters from the top of the airplane along this edge. And 24 millimeter from this point along this edge. Let's do our fold. And let's do the middle fold to match. Now again, we need to measure 31 millimeters from this point along this edge. In this way, and let's make a fold from this point up to this point here. Let's make this fold a little bit strong on this side. And now let's make a fold from the same point up to the top. This will be obviously a squash fold at the end. And do your squash fold. Let's do the same thing on the other side, 31 millimeters. Fold precisely up to the end of the tail. Let's do the second fold. This will make our life easy when we do the squash fold. And finally, squash. Now let's make another fold from the top up to this point here. You see, you can mark this point here, coincident with this portion. And let's do another fold. Here there are many layers to be folded, but it should not be a big problem. Let's do the same fold in the other side. In this way. And now we need to open and we need to invert all the folds that we have done by putting this the tail portion underneath the wings as I shown you before. So let's open. This way, let's invert these two poles. Let's put again our fold underneath the wings, and let's start inverting all the folds. The squash fold. Except the last one we will keep it as it is, and we will fold inside in this way. Okay, let's do the same the other side. The squash fold. And the last fold. And this is what you're getting now. Okay, now let's shape the stabilizers in this way. Take this portion of paper, fold it until here, maximum that you can, in this way, and fold this one until this point here. So do something like this. Okay. Do the same thing in the other side, and at this point, if you have done the model precise enough, the two stabilizers should have exactly the same shape. Okay, now turn the wing in this way, creating another fold. And now I ask you to be patient, because we need to reopen everything, because we need to do a shaping of these things here. Open in this way, bring these wings over the wing in this way, turn the stabilizer in this way, and let's measure now 8 millimeters from this point along the line. You can see now you have two lines, one down, one up, to the line that is down, you measure 8 millimeters. Now, make a fold from this point up to this point here. In this way, open up and make another fold from this point up to the same mark. Okay, now before proceeding with the inversion, I need to do the same thing in the other side. Okay, now open and we have done this exercise in some other planes. You will see that you have three folds in this side and three folds in this side. Now, with the paper in this position, the first fold this side and the first fold this side will be a mountain fold. The two folds in the middle will be valley fold, and the two last folds will be again mountain fold. Let's do it. Mountain fold. Mountain fold. The last again. Mountain fold. And mountain fold, and the middle one, valley fold, and valley fold. Let's do the same thing in the other side, mountain fold, mountain fold, again the last mountain fold, mountain fold, and the middle one, valley fold, and valley fold. Now, let's fold again, and let's make the, I don't know how to say, let's collapse the folds that we have done. Like here, you need to squash a little bit down the paper, and you will have now this shape of the stabilizer. Let's do the same. And let's squash it down. In this way. Now we are ready to refold back the airplane, so let's bring inside this one again and let's refold all the folds that we have done. Now it should be easy because the poles are already done. And this is what we have. So now you can notice that this portion of the tail is going under the wing for a certain extent, that it should be around, let's say, from 7 to 8 millimeters. In this case, it's 8 millimeters, and in this case, it's 7 millimeters. This is because I was not enough precise, but this is not a problem. Now turn the plane in this way and and measure 5 millimeters from this point along this edge here. 5 millimeters, and make a fold from this point here, which is the point where exactly where the wings cross the tail. This point here. Make a fold from this point up to the 5 millimeters mark. Just one thing, just fold this wing inside, because you don't have to fold the vertical stabilizer. We have to fold only the horizontal stabilizer. And fold. In this way, you will have the shape of the tail, like the Tomcat. Now let's do the same fold in the other side. Let's measure again 5 millimeters here. Let's bring the vertical stabilizer inside, so we will not fold it. And let's do the same fold. So if you now turn your airplane, you will have this shape. Now let's turn back the wing, just leave a couple of millimeters, and fold it in a way that this line here, not the external line, this line here will be parallel with this one. But give something like 2 millimeters. And fold it in this way. Now let's try to fold the other wings in the same way. So let's put the airplane in this position and let's try to match the other piece. Okay, now we have done this double fold. Let's open now this double fold, both sides, and let's fold, rotate, turn the paper, and let's fold this one inside, because we don't want this projection of paper to be there. So how we will do this? We will put again the wings in this way, and we will fold this one like this in both sides. Now let's open again the wing. Let's fold this one inside in this way, and let's bring this fold up to this point here. You can do this by hand. These are the small folds that you don't need to use actually a ruler or something. Now, when we turn the wing in this way, you can squash this fold. So what you are getting now is the exact shape of both vertical and horizontal stabilizers. Of course, we still need to make a small fold in this way, and still we need to shape a little bit the vertical stabilizer, but this we'll do it later on. Let's do the same thing now here, opening this way, bring this fold inside, continue the other fold up to this point. Now the folds are not laying flat, but you will see that when you redo the first fold of the wings, this one will lay flat. And now you can do the second fold again. Now, the very good news now is that we are ready with the swinging of the wing. Now, let's put the stabilizers in this way. And let's do the swinging mechanism. If you look inside the wings, you will see that actually this one will work as the swinging mechanism. So what you have to do now is make another two small folds, in order that when the wings is in this position, it will actually lay on the small fold that we have done. So let's start to facilitate this additional fold that we want to do by making just by opening these and making two pre-folds. Then let's now force the wings to go down. Let's find the place where we want actually our wing to lay. And let's do these two additional fold. You will have one, you will have two. Now you have the fold in this position. At the same time, we need to fold this one. We need to make another fold in this way. Make this flat. And let's close, creating the two additional folds. And let's fold this one as well. Now, what we need to do now is to bring back and forth for a couple of times the wing in this way. You can see now what actually happened. You see, you have two series of folds, one for the wing in the normal position and one for the wing that is swept. Now let's do the same on the other side. Let's start forcing and let's facilitate the creation of these two additional folds by folding a little bit this paper in this way. Let's bring exactly the wing in the position that we want. It will be now this position, and let's close it. Then let's do this exercise for a couple of times. First fold and the second fold here. First fold and the second fold. Okay, this, at the end of the day, this mechanism will be, I don't know if you will be able to do it the first time, but it can be done only in this way. There is no pre-fold that you can do in order to do this mechanism. Anyway, let's bring now the wings in a fully open position. And let's prepare the plane for the final fold. Now turn now the plane and measure 52 millimeter from the top along the center line. Make a mark here. And 12 millimeters from this point along this edge and from this point along this edge. And let's do our final fold. Now, let's close it. Sorry, I will get one clip. And here we are. Then, as I told you before, we need to bring this paper here inside this pocket. Okay, this is not strictly necessary, but it will make your plane a little bit stronger. And if you want, you can shape a little bit the pancake in this way to make it more similar to the real F-14. Now, let's verify once again the swinging mechanism. Actually, the more you will swing the wings, the more the wings, they will become easy to swing. And most probably, when you turn the wings up, you will need to take this paper out of the pocket, because you need to bring the wings exactly where they were before. But this is not a big problem. You can reclose the airplane, or you can leave this one open if you want. There is no problem. This, in my model, I didn't put this one inside, and the plane is still very stable. No tape, no glue. The wings of the plane are really very strong. Now, let's make the last small folds. First of all, we need to make a small fold on this, on the horizontal stabilizer. Just make a small fold in this way. A small fold here and a small fold here, and the plane is done. If you want, you can make a small fold also here, just to shape a little bit more the wing in this way, but it's not really necessary. I mean, the shape is almost the same than the F-14. And your plane is done. Thanks for watching, and to the next tutorial.